Hey guys, this is Pokemon Spirit Gold, video number 83. In the last video, we got the rock climb from Professor Oak, and we came back to Johto and did some rock climbing. So, in this video, we're going to take the SS Aqua ship and battle some of the trainers on the SS Aqua. And to battle the SS Aqua, I need to get my guys out from the box. I had Snorlax in my team so that I could, you know, rock climb. But I'm not going to be rock climbing on the boat, so put Snorlax in, get Caesar out. And yeah, now we're going to go to the boat. Alright, Q-tip. Let's go board the SS Aqua. I guess leaves on Mondays and Fridays. Okay. Well, I don't really remember what day of the week it was that I played this video, but apparently it wasn't a Monday or a Friday, so I'm gonna go to Goldenrod City and take the train to Kanto. You know, the only good thing for taking the boat is battling the trainers, because you can get to Kanto a lot quicker than the boat, okay? I'm just saying. You can take the magnet train. Or, what you can do is fly to the Indigo Plateau, and then from there, fly to Kanto. It's kind of funny. You can fly, like, you can fly from Kanto. You can't fly from Kanto to Johto, but no matter which one you're in, you can still fly to the Indigo Plateau, and then from there, fly to wherever the hell you want to go. The Indigo Plateau and Victory Road. That's kind of like, you know, oh, I'm here, and I can go anywhere. You know what? I just remembered something. I know I said in the last video that I was going to, crap, but that's gonna take some work, though. I don't know, maybe I'll try it out. Something that I wanted to do was, rebattle all the gym leaders. And, you can do that at the Fighting Dojo, but you gotta, it's weird, because it's like a certain time of the week and day that you go and find, like, there's a certain time of the day and week that you go and find the gym leader somewhere, not at their gym. Like, for instance, you run into Brock at Diglett's Cave on a certain day of the week. I don't remember what day of the week, but I just know that because I ran into him while I was at Diglett's Cave, just, you know, by chance. And then they tell you, oh, call me at this time. And you say, and you call them at that time, and then they'll say, okay, I'll have a rematch with you. So there's like two different like times that you have to meet up with them. But I might actually do that before I battle Red, because that'll probably be some good experience. And, well, I'll have to see what levels their Pokemon are at, because if they're pretty high, then I might battle Red first. But if not, I might do that first. And then I'll go and face the Elite Four again. That'll be good, like, grinding stuff. Yeah. That might be a good idea. Okay. Anyway, we're here on the SS Aqua now. Apparently, it is a Wednesday or a Sunday. When I was playing this, it was probably a Sunday. So, I'm here battling the trainers on the SS Aqua, going from Kanto to Johto. And it'll always be the same batch of trainers, unless he's Draenor's done something like different. But it'll always be the same batch of trainers going from Kanto to Johto, but then a different batch of trainers going from Johto to Kanto, and that batch will always be the same as well. So you have basically two batches of trainers depending on which route you're taking. But anyway, you know, it's a decent place to you know, level up, get some experience. One thing that I don't have in this video that, or in this playthrough, that I did have in Blaze Black that came in very handy was the Lucky Egg. The Lucky Egg, if you don't know, is an item that when your Pokemon is holding it, they'll gain more experience per battle than they normally would. And Emblaze Black, you got the Lucky Egg from Professor Juniper in Chargestone Cave. And, well, actually, in Black and White, you get it from her in Chargestone Cave. But in Blaze Black, she actually gives you 6 Lucky Eggs so that you can give one to each of your Pokemon, because it kind of becomes a hassle having to switch the Lucky Egg out from whoever's in front of your team. And then if you end up, you know, switching out from them in the battle, then, you know, the Pokemon you switch into doesn't get the extra experience. So it's kind of nice to have all those Lucky Eggs, and I might see if I can find one here. A lot of Lucky Eggs, or most Lucky Eggs, no, let me rephrase that. A lot of Wild Chansey like to hold Lucky Eggs. So if you can find a Wild Chansey and catch it, it might be holding a Lucky Egg. And I think the Chansey are over there on route, what is it, 14? Over there between Fuchsia City and Lavender Town. I think that's where the Wild Chansey are. But yeah, I might see if I can find a Lucky Egg before I take on Red, because that will make raising my Pokemon a lot easier than just the normal way of going around battling people. And what I'll probably end up doing to raise my Pokemon is just is either battling the trainers here on this boat, but as you can see, their Pokemon are leveled quite lower than mine. So I might see if the Elite Four aren't too tough, trying to battle them over and over again. And that'll be a good way to get my Pokemon levels up. Anyway, Q-Tip uses Fly on this Scyther, and that is a critical hit. That is a... well, it's not a critical hit, it's a super effective hit. I don't know why I said critical hit. Anyway, here's Pinsir, and I'm gonna have Q-Tip do the same thing to it. Have it go up and fly, and Pinsir's gonna be like, no! Q-Tip's gonna be like, bam, Pinsir, you suck. What you think now? And Pinsir's gonna be like, oh my goodness! Yeah, that's what happens. Alright, that was actually some pretty decent experience there for Q-Tip. Okay, I guess we'll go into the next room now. And just so you know, the room directly, like, catty-cornered from the room I just went in, is your room. So you can go in there. If you take a nap on the bed, your Pokemon will be healed. And also, the ship will have docked. So there's that if you're just looking to get off the ship. And there's also a PC in there, so you can, if you need to, like, change out your team or something for whatever reason. You know, if you had your HM Slave in your party like I did, but forgot to switch it out, you know, that might be a good thing. Anyway, this Electivire just killed my Q-Tip, so that makes me sad. So I'll send in Donovan, and Donovan Electivire is going to use Close Combat, which will probably do some pretty decent damage, maybe. Or not, you know, whatever. Donovan's just going to use Earthquake and be like, oh, Earthquake! And Electivire is going to be like, no, you suck, I'm going to die. But, you know, those are the waters. Critical hit. It's super effective. Oh. Okay, Donovan gained 2173. Donovan grew to level 64. Woohoo! Player defeated guitarist Clyde. Yowza! Total distortion. And I got all kinds of experience for winning. Or not experience, but money. I didn't get crap for experience. Well, maybe I did. Who knows? I wasn't really looking at the experience, to be honest. Let's see. This looks like it could be a potential double battle. I don't even know who the second one in my party is. I hope it's someone good. What do you think? My Pokemon are beautiful, yes? Well, we'll have to see. Oh, you've got your kid dressed up as a Pikachu. Pokefan Georgia and Jeremy. She sends in a Ferret, and he sends in a Persian. So that's alright. I'll send in Jethro and Tundra. And have Jethro use Petal Dance, and Tundra can use Ice Beam. And yeah, they'll just, like, you know, dominate. So that's the Ice Beam on the level 49 Persian, which is a one-hit KO. One-hit KO. Petal Dance is also a one-hit KO, so that's cool. We'll just keep ice beaming and pedal dancing these Pokemon's faces off. So now she has another Ferret, and this guy has a Perugly. So I think we'll just do the same thing. The old ice beam and pedal dance ploy seemed to work out pretty well the last time. Ice beam on the Perugly. Will that kill it? Hopefully it will. Yes. No. Yet. No, it didn't. Okay. Pedal dance should kill the Ferret though, since it killed the last one. Yeah. Jethro used pedal dance, and that's a dead Ferret. Jethro and Tundra gain experience, and she's gonna send another Ferret now. So I guess Jethro will use pedal dance on that, and I'll have to kill this Perugly with Tundra. He used body slam on Tundra, which didn't do too much. I'm just glad that it didn't paralyze me. So Earth Power, and that's it for Perugly. Jethro gained experience, Tundra gained experience, and Jethro used Pedal Dance. Okay, that's a dead Ferret. And now Jethro's confused. She has another Ferret, so she actually has four Ferrets. And this guy is sitting in Delcatty. So they actually... I think these are both their last Pokemons. So they actually have a total of seven Pokemon to battle, which is kind of different, but hey, it's fine. You know, that's just more experience for me. I'll have Tundra use Ice Beam on the Delcatty. Hopefully that'll be a one-hitter. Hopefully. Being the key word, and it is, so that's cool. Delcatty fainted. Jethro and Tundra. Jethro flinched. Ferret tried to use Rest, because Ferret is a failure at life. So now I'll have Tundra use Ice Beam on this thing, because Tundra's faster than Jethro, so it'll get its attack off first. And it looks like Jethro doesn't need to attack, because Tundra killed it. Jethro's confused. And it hurt itself in its confusion. Oh, now she has a Clefable, look at that. Eight Pokemon, I guess, huh? Right? Because she had four Ferrets, and now she has a Clefable. And the other guy had the three cat Pokemons. I know there's technically four cat Pokemons, but this is a Gen 4 game, so, you know, the other one wasn't around yet. I'm talking about Liepard. I don't know about you guys, but I'm looking forward to Black 2 and White 2. I've watched a couple of videos on YouTube of, like, the first, like, part of the game, like, Pokemon Black 2 video 1s of a couple of people, but I haven't, like, really been watching a full playthrough yet. Hopefully I'll watch one. If any of you guys who are watching this are doing a playthrough of, you know, Black 2 or White 2, let me know and I'll check it out. Because I'm kind of looking for one to watch. Well, not really. I haven't really started looking for one, but if y'all tell me about, you know, one that you're doing or one that you know of that's pretty good, then, you know, I'll check it out. Because I'm definitely excited about this game. I'll tell you what I'm even more excited about is Blaze Black 2 and Volt White 2. Oh. I'm sorry, guy, that I don't remember your name. You commented on one of my Storm Silver videos. I want to say it was Storm Silver 26 or 27 that Dreyano announced in one of his videos that he is going to do a Blaze Black 2 and Volt White 2. Again, I don't remember who you were, but that's a shout out to you, whoever you are. So it sounds like he is going to make one, so that's good news for me and other people who like to play those games and watch those LPs. So if he makes one, I will definitely be doing an LP of it, because Blaze Black was my very first LP ever that I did, and you know, I guess it's only fitting that I do Blaze Black or Volt White 2. I'll probably do Blaze Black 2 just to kind of continue on my last one, and I'll probably do just White 2 of the actual game. You know what? I do plan on doing an LP of that game when it comes out. October 7th is when it's coming out. And that'll actually be the first time I've done an LP of a non-hack game, if you don't count Fire Red, which I tend to not count Fire Red because that LP was just... In my opinion, it wasn't good. I don't know. The idea was good, but it the actual thing itself wasn't good. To me, at least. I got bored with that game really quickly. And I think it was just because of the way I played it, just using Charizard. I tried to put a little twist on it, a fun twist on it, and I shouldn't have. I should have just played it. No, actually what I should have done was just gone straight into this game. That's what I should have done. But yeah, like I said, I'm looking forward to those new games, and I'm looking forward to the potential Blaze Black and Vault White 2 sequels that Draiano might be making to his Blaze Black and Vault White games. Anyway, we're down on the lower deck of the ship now. This guy here sent in a Mad Champ, which hopefully won't kill me. Oh, stop! Yes, super effective. Sandstorm Rage is on. Actually, it's really freaking effective because of my dual typing. That would suck, though, to get one hit KO'd by a Pokemon that's 15 levels lower than you. The leftovers restore a little bit of health. I'll use Crunch on the Machamp, and that'll be a dead Machamp, so that's cool. The Sandstorm Rage is on, and leftovers will get me back up to 61 HP. Now he's going to send in Poliwrath, and yeah, you know, if I don't knock out that Poliwrath in one hit, it's going to come after me and probably kill me. So I'll send in Jethro, because Poliwrath's a water type, and Jethro's a grass type, and that usually tends to be a pretty good matchup for the grass type. So, Poliwrath. Jethro used Petal Dance. And you know, and it took me, on my Storm Silver, it took me forever to, well, not forever, but like a couple of videos to where I started calling Jericho, Jericho, and not Jethro. And since that's the game I've been playing lately a lot, you might hear me slip a Jericho in for Jethro when I actually mean Jethro. So, just, you know, bear with that. Anyway, we took down the Poliwrath, and now he sends in this Tentacruel, and I'm going to send in Pure Mayhem because he needs the experience, and I think he can one-hit KO this thing with Earthquake since it is super effective and Pure Mayhem is pretty strong. That would have been bad if Tentacruel used a water type attack on me, because then I pretty much would have been dead. But yeah, Pure Mayhem got the 2107 experience, and Sandstorm Rages. Is there more? Does he have more Pokemon? Oh, okay, he has a Primeape. So I think I will take Pure Mayhem out, and send in someone else, probably Caesar. I guess that's who it looks like, Caesar. Okay, Caesar will use Close Combat. My stats fell, but that's okay, because the Primeape is dead, and this should be his last Pokemon. Yes, Sailor Kenneth defeated. Your lack of training is obvious. Yes, it is. Okay, no one over here. Anyone in here? No. Just a bunch of beds. That must be like where the staff sleeps. Let's see. Oh, yeah. We got the teacher and the field trip kids. Don't lay a finger on my students. I won't, but, you know, I can't say the same for my Pokemon not laying a finger on their Pokemon. That sounded weird. No, my Pokemon will just knock theirs out, and then they'll have to go heal them. Go sleep in the bed for a little while, and then their Pokemon will be all okay. Anyway, this Chatot is using Hyper Voice, which is like a, you know, he's using a voice, but it's hyper. And I'm using Stone Edge, and that's super effective against this Chatot. Remember back when I had my annoying Pokemon list? Chatot was on that list. Oh, I actually have it right here, and Chatot was the first one on that list too. So, yeah, Chatot's pretty annoying. He was the first Pokemon to make it onto my official annoying Pokemon list. Anyway, she's sending in a Wigglytuff now, so I'm sending in Caesar, who can probably take this thing out with one hit. And when I say probably, I mean he can. I mean, why wouldn't he take out this Wigglytuff with one hit? Unless it's holding like a Focus Sash or something, which would be stupid. But no, it's super effective, and Caesar's defenses go down, but that's alright, because Wigglytuff's dead, and Caesar's now at level 64, and that's it. We're done with this here teacher person. Surely. Ack, said she. Oh, are you now? Don't know him personally, but I've been there. We're not like buddies or anything. You're challenged by school kid Nate. And he sends in a Ledian, which is perfect, because I have this here pure mayhem. And Ledian, I know it's part bug, I think it's also part flying. So Stone Edge should do a crap load of damage to this thing. And the fact that I'm 11 levels higher, that's kind of a tongue twister. 11 levels higher than this thing doesn't hurt either. So that's a Stone Edge, and it's really freaking effective, and that's a dead Ledian. Okay, Pure Mayhem restored its HP. Now I'm gonna, now she's gonna send an Exeggutor. An Exeggutor is a grass slash psychic type. One of the original ones. Original 150. Before there was actually 151, there was just 150. And Exeggutor is one of those. And he fell to the crunch. That's how it goes. Pure Mayhem is now at level 64. And we defeated Nate. Now we'll defeat his little compadre here. But not before we switch the Pokemon order here. I guess I'll leave. I'll just leave him there. Okay, this is school kid Ricky. Like Ricky Ricardo. Alright, so he sends in an Ambipom. Hopefully this thing doesn't have, like, a fighting type move or something. I know some of these Ambipoms will have a fighting type move. But I'm gonna have Pure Mayhem use Earthquake, and hopefully maybe that'll knock it out. I don't know. Earthquake's a pretty strong move, but Ambipom actually has some decent stats, so no, it wasn't quite enough. But the Sandstorm rages, doesn't it? And Ambipom is buffeted by the Sandstorm, and that knocked it out, so you've got the whole Earthquake-Sandstorm combo going. You know, that Sandstorm can kind of come back to bite you sometimes, especially when you're trying to catch a legendary Pokemon. You'll see in the videos that are to come, when I go to catch legendary Pokemon, I can't use Pure Mayhem, because he has that Sandstorm, and that just does continual damage. And, you know, you just can't have that when you're trying to catch a legendary Pokemon. Because you got to get their HP down to as low as you can without knocking them out. And then, you know, try and catch them. But with that Sandstorm, I mean, it's going to knock them out every time. So, we're done, basically, with them. Let's see, there's nothing up here to do. So we'll just go up the ladder. That's the engine room right there. And we'll go visit the captain. What's up, Captain? Captain Crunch? Captain? Oh, okay, so he gives us a flame plate. Put the flame plate in the items pocket. Yeah, it's great. The ride, the SS Aqua's ride. It's, like, wonderful. Okay, so we're done down here, and we're done up at the top, too, so What I have to do now is go into my room and take a nap, and then that way the ship will show up at the dock. I'm all healed. And the fast ship SS Aqua has arrived in Olivine City, so I'm like, yay! What do you think, Pure Mayhem? He's dancing along with the rolling of the ship, even though the ship really isn't rolling much because it's standing still. But hey, whatever floats your boat, Pure Mayhem. Okay, so we're back in Olivine City, and hopefully, well, yeah, in the next video, I think we're going to take the fast ship back to Vermilion City, so kind of, you know, stick around for that if you want to see it. I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye.